Hello, my name is Joe, and welcome to a quick vlog update for Joe's Super Fantabulous PC Gaming Channel, where I've been busy lately. So if you haven't seen me on video sharing sites or streaming, busy. I went back to school, and it was a part of a New Year's resolution I decided to make good on, and I've been having a good time. Actually got an A for my very first course, and
I was.
all these phone calls in GTA. I'm always like, look, leave me alone, phone calls. I just want to have fun driving around the world. Oh boy. And because I'm always popular, I have a bounty. So I've been having fun with school. Been spending a lot of time at work.
I almost crapped
Just
myself.
seems like there's no end of work, although I'm not complaining, not really. There are many people who, whoops, there's another belligerent phone call. Go away. Who don't have enough to do. Thankfully, I'm at this point where if someone were to ask my management, so what does that Joe guy do here? And they're like, well, how much time do you got? Because fortunately, I do lots of things. It's good to be needed. It's even better when I'll take a day off and then I come back and people are like, oh, Joe, thank goodness you're back. All this stuff happened while you were gone. Could you please help? And I'm like, sure, no problem. I take all the jobs that nobody else wants to do. Whoops! Oh! I wish I could blame alcohol for this driving, but this is all me. Oh well. Here, we'll just pull it in here. Fortunately, I was going to say it's a rental, but in this case, it's a carjacked vehicle. That way I can drive around someone else's car and smash it up without having to pay for repairs. So usually I don't drive my own cars around in GTA Online unless I'm playing a closed session with friends. But, for just random people as I go around town, like this is my arcade here. As you can see, it's kind of anime themed. I've tried to fill it with as many arcade games as I can in order to get a nice little passive income. The arcade generates money. Let's see, how much money do you have for me? Oh, it's just like real life. The safe is empty. Oh well. Oh, you know what? I realized what it was is that I probably emptied the safe right at the point where I logged out the last time. So I haven't been logged in long enough for the arcade to generate any money. So, the longer you're logged in, the more passive income you get. It's just the arcade, the safe has a maximum capacity of $50,000, and after that, the money is wasted. So I want to, I have that urge to check it often because I don't want to lose money. So anyways, I've been having fun with work and school. So that takes up a lot of my time. As a result, I haven't been able to devote as much time to video sharing and streaming. However, there were some barriers that I'm not going to go into that had prevented me from monetizing my channels, but they've all been taken care of. And so now, with all the bills that I've got, maybe I can help myself a little bit by monetizing my channels. That is, assuming that my content is entertaining enough for anybody to want to watch, Oh, and on the plus side, I've been having fun with Elder Scrolls Online still. I'm actually looking forward to the upcoming chapter of ESO. As you can see, I'm one of those kids that never outgrew the joy of honking the horn. So as I go through Los Santos here, I just love to just lean on this. Whoa! This horn. Whoops! Uh-oh. Yeah, run for your life, pedestrians. Joe's on the road. Your life is measured in seconds. Honk, honk. So I'm looking forward to High Tide. It looks like it's going to be a lot of fun, especially since in the new chapter they're finally adding a Khajiit companion. Who's morally flexible? I am absolutely sick and tired of Bastion and Miri rolling their eyes and weeping and gnashing their teeth every time I commit another murder with the Blade of Woe. I'm hoping that finally I have a Khajiit companion. It's like, eh, he probably had it coming, and just, sits there and just turns a blind eye as I stab people, so that I don't have to constantly have to dismiss my companion. So that I don't lose. Oh, what the hell? No valet parking? Well, fine. No tip for you. Not only that, but here, let me give you a little parting gift here. right to the back of the head. And for all you filthy animals, you know, GTA is very therapeutic after a long day of having to put up with a bunch of crap. I don't have to put up with anything in here, so I have to come in here and just shoot people. I hate people, I tell you what. Alright, well, let's see, because GTA logic, as soon as you get into the casino, you're totally safe, because police can't touch you in the casino. So here, I'll just clean myself up. Obviously, I'm dressed for the casino, and there's a story behind this character, but I don't think I'll tell it here. Maybe someday while I'm streaming, but there's a reason she looks the way she does. She's actually patterned after somebody I used to know. So let's see if we get lucky on the lucky wheel today. You know, there's a trick to the lucky wheel where if you count out so many seconds from the time that you spin based on the position the vehicle is at, you can get the wheel to give it to you. Let's see. Ta-da. Let's spin, spin, spin. And watching that vehicle go around. And hey, look at that. All right. Excellent. Well, I think I've got space in the office garage on level 3. Excellent. So I won whatever that is on the podium. Well, that'll be fun to try that out. But no, I'm looking forward to the next chapter of ESO. I also have a bunch of titles that are in my ESO, or I said ESO, Steam library that I have never gotten around to playing. So I thought of having fun doing some playthroughs of that. Now that I'm finally going to be able to monetize my channels, there are a whole bunch of tutorials that I was planning on making. One of the things that I've seen about YouTube is that there's, you know, different kinds of content. There's content that's in the moment, you know, the news channels where they're like, oh, I got to get my content out and monetize within a certain amount of time because then the interest drops off if I'm, you know, slow to the punch, you know. I can't do that. I just don't have the time to chase whatever the most current relevant event of the day is. Mine's going to be the more boring stuff that never goes out of style, like, imagine a whole course on, so you want to learn Visual Basic scripting? You know, here we have, and 35 easy lessons, you know? Oh boy, they hit this guy. Well, you know what, let's finish him off, yeah, because I care. Just showing the love here. Yeah, just drag him out of the wheels. So, I'm actually putting together lesson plans right now, and going to put together some little educational tutorials, and yeah, if anybody's interested in them. The fun part about it is that, you know, if you have one interesting video that a lot of people watch, you get a few pennies here and there for that one video being popular. But if you make a course that's a series of videos where it's like, all right, you know, let's see if you're interested, and people are like, wow, this is really good and informative, and I actually learned something. I want to see the other 26 videos in this series. Well, now you get to monetize them, you know, 27 times instead of just one for each topic. So I'm going to try to be as thorough as possible. Now, this is the part I'm kind of bracing for, is, and this kind of happened when I first started one of my other channels where I made an educational video. And the video is all on my own desktop, and it's just me talking, and someone had the gall to copyright strike it because they wanted to be the one and only channel that ever made tutorials on a particular topic. Well, that's obviously an abuse of the copyright system, but YouTube apparently allows that, so I know that someone is going to try to come after my channels if they get popular for doing tutorials, and so I have to be ready for that. So that's the only part I dread, is having to deal with nonsense. I'm not going to use anybody else's copyrighted material. I'll make my own pictures, you know, because I've seen these things where they're like, they'll strike you if you use an illustration from anybody else's stuff or anything. Whoops! Oh, I should have let the car stop before I, you know, come to a full and complete stop before you exit the vehicle, you know. Oh well, I blame you, random people. Yeah, give me a dollar. There we go inside here before the police show up. Otherwise, I won't be able to get into the office. Oh, wait a minute. This isn't the office. I went to the apartment by mistake. Well, I have an apartment across the street from the office, so... Whoops. oh, well. Well, I'm here. I guess I might as well loosen up. I mean, it's been a long, hard day. I'm about to go test drive a new car. So, obviously, that means that I need some alcohol. Yeah. Let's have a drink or two. Or maybe three. So, here, let's see. Got some nice, let's see, I'll say that this is probably burgundy. Mm. Or maybe a nice Merlot. Apparently it agrees with her. So we'll have another. I love how she takes in the aroma, savors the taste. Obviously a wine connoisseur. Instead of, you know, your regular grocery store wine that you just take the bottle, pop out the cork, and start swigging it. You know. Yeah, there we go. I'm starting to feel it now. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm starting to metabolize this stuff. When everything looks like this, that means we're ready to get behind the wheel. Time for a test drive. Now, fortunately, our new car is right across the street, so just have to go across to the office here. And let's see, if we go to the garage entrance, we can go straight up to the parking garage instead of having to go through the office proper. Okay, there we go. And I put it on level 3. This is where I store all my silly vehicles. These trucks come from a magic car lot. I like to sell them to Los Santos Customs. Some other weird vehicles that I picked up. Here we go. And here's the new car, which I don't even know what it's called. Oh, an Ocelot. That's why I didn't know what this thing was called. It's actually written on the car, if I was paying attention. Well, let's see how it drives. Whoops. Oh, well, since I had a few drinks, well, it drives really fast, but keeping it on the road will be a challenge. Oh well. Seems to be doing okay. So anyways, I'm planning on, like I said, turning on the monetization for all my channels and pumping out a bit more content than I have been for a while. It's just, you know, with work and with school and the fact that I was doing it for a hobby, there's only so much time I could allocate. But if it will help me to pay a few bills, you know what? I can go ahead and this can be sort of like my second job. So I'm going to see if I can't have some fun with doing some playthroughs of games that, like for example, I'm still doing a playthrough of the entire Elder Scrolls Online. That will take a long time. But you know what? It's a lot of fun. I'm enjoying ESO quite a bit, so I have no regrets about playing through things. Oh, plus, one of the things that I'm looking forward to is in the next chapter of ESO, they're going to make it so that achievements are account-wide. So my character that is doing all of the questing right now and earning a whole bunch of achievements for herself, all of her achievements will become the achievements of all my characters very soon. So I'm looking forward to that. But the Khajiit Companion is pretty good. Oh, and they also have a deconstruction assistant, which is coming. Of course, I've already seen the predictable moaning where people are like, oh, it's going to be locked behind a 5,000 crown, blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, you know, it's a convenience. You can deconstruct things for free at any one of a myriad number of towns and cities, but if you want to be able to call the deconstructor to you, yeah, you're going to have to pay a crown fee. Oh, well, buy the crowns when they're on sale. That's what I do. And, That way, it's not that, it doesn't hurt quite that much. So, I mean, I could wait for them to just kind of accumulate from my ESO Plus membership, but I'm impatient. The moment that deconstructor is available, I'm going to get that assistant. So, gotta have them all. It's like Pokemon. Whoops, I wish I could blame the alcohol, but I think the alcohol is worn off by this point, so. This car drives pretty well, especially since it was free. So I will have a lot more fun in Grand Theft Auto Online. If you're curious, if you notice my character doesn't seem to have a lot of money, it's because mostly for me, GTA is just kind of a place to unwind. I have more fun driving around and running over people than I do with dealing with heists or anything, you know, fancy or anything else. For me, it's just more fun to just kind of cruise around and just be a general menace to society. In the real world, I have to be a very nice person. I have responsibilities, people that depend on me, and in Grand Theft Auto, if people look at me cockeyed, I'll just punch them in the face and shoot them. So it's a nice place to relieve stress. Okay, well, I'm going to get back to doing silly things, and actually looking forward to having more fun with all of you online, and you guys will see a bit more of me. If you're curious, you're like, okay, Joe, so if you're really going to monetize your channels, how serious are you going to be about it? Serious enough that I actually built a computer especially for processing and uploading all the videos. Now, I've had some in the past, but not like this. This thing's got like 8 hard drives in it so that it can chew up all kinds of videos. And if you're wondering why, it's because, well, I record it at the highest resolution I can, but then I have to transcode for multiple different video formats and sites. And so this machine just is going to sit in the corner, and that's all it does all the time. It's been put together for a little while. It just hasn't had a permanent home, so I'm actually in the process. Ah, darn it. You know what? You messed up my nice free car. That's the penalty. So, I'm looking forward to getting that set up, get its permanent home, and that way, we're going to see that the, at least the video sharing sites will always have a regular amount of content. So, start getting them busy again. I'm just debating whether or not I should have new videos every day or every other day. It'll be easier to queue them up further out into the future if it's every other day. I'm just debating, you know, how my little sharing schedule will be. So it might be every other day. There's only so many hours in a day that I can put things together anyways for you guys. So the bad part is, though, is that once the monetization turns on, you're going to see some commercials. But if you'll be nice enough not to block them and let them run, it'll put a couple of extra pennies in my pocket to help offset the expenses for some of the silly things that I've done in the past, like computers that I bought. But if not, you know, if you want to go ahead and use an ad blocker, that's fine too. Because either way, it's just put up here for fun. If I make any money at all, that's just gravy. All right, well, let's see. I guess I'll have fun continuing to be a menace here to society in Grand Theft Auto Online, and I will have fun seeing all of you in lots of other games soon. Like I said, I was thinking of doing some playthroughs of some other titles that have been in my Steam library and I've been neglected for some time. I figure it's a way to kind of jumpstart my channel again. It seems like I'm always relaunching my channel. Well, now that I'm finally okay to finally start monetizing, this time it's going to stay. Because when money's involved, people suddenly get motivated, right? You know, gotta pay the bills. No matter what, the electric company always wants money every month, the gas company wants money every month, you know, and so forth and so on. So, always finding new creative ways to pay. I'm just doing it without being a criminal in real life. See you next time. Guess nobody wants this briefcase. I enjoy these silly events, even the ones that everyone ignores.